In today's digitally interconnected world, having a social media presence is essential. And what could be a better way to showcase it than by using cool animations that sit right on top of the profile picture? Such fun animations not only add flair to the website, but also provide quick access to various social platforms, inviting viewers to explore further. But first, hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell if you haven't already, so you never miss out on our web dev tutorials. Let's begin. All right, let's start by setting up the layout. We create a section with the CSS class profile cards attached to it. Inside, we will have a separate div for each card tagged with the class profile card. This is where the profile image will go. After that, we add a plus icon inside a separate div. As we are using Bootstrap icons for this project, we will include their CDN in the head section of the web page. Before moving forward, let me quickly replicate this markup to add a few more images. In the CSS, we have already set up the basic styles for our page and its title. Now, let's dive into the aesthetics of profile cards. First, we transform the profile cards section into a CSS grid. Using grid template columns set to 1FR, we'll create a single column layout with a separation of 1rem. Then, we use media queries to adjust the number of columns based on screen size. For screens narrower than 576 pixels, the grid will stick to a single column layout. Between 576 to 767 pixels, it will switch to two columns. A three-column layout will come into effect for screens between 768 and 991 pixels. And finally, for anything wider than that, a four-column layout will be maintained. After that, the profile image will have both the width and height of 100% to fill the entire div. The object fit property is set to cover to maintain the original aspect ratio, preventing images from looking stretched. Additionally, we set the aspect ratio CSS property for the parent div. This will dynamically adjust the height based on its width, resulting in a responsive layout. Setting the ratio to 1 by 1.25 will maintain a height that's 125% of the width, creating a balanced look without making images too small or too large. Now let's give some style to the plus icon. This will be positioned absolutely within its parent div. The combo of a fixed width and aspect ratio of 1 will create a perfect square. Converting it into a flex container and then setting justify content and align items to the center is an easy way to keep the icon perfectly centered. Furthermore, the parent div will need relative positioning to ensure the icon stays in its absolute position. Since we will be using these positions and widths in multiple places, let's store them in custom properties. Custom properties in CSS allow us to define values once and use them wherever needed. It's a handy way to maintain consistency throughout the style sheet. If you're interested in learning more about custom properties, feel free to check out our comprehensive video on the topic. Next up, let's add the last building blocks of our layout. We once again make use of the Bootstrap icons library to showcase our social profiles. Each icon is wrapped in an anchor tag with the CSS class icon social. In our design, the social icons have a similar style and positioning as the plus icon we added earlier. So we can reuse the same CSS rule set. Because each icon is placed at an exact location, they are stacked on top of each other. This means the last icon, Instagram in this case, is visible at the top. However, we wanted to keep the plus icon at the very top. This can easily be fixed by changing their stacking order. We simply need to add the z-index property with a value of 1 for the plus icon. It's time to shift our focus to the hover effect. We will utilize the hover pseudo-class to update the presentation style for the plus icon. With the help of the transition property, the background color will smoothly transition over a period of 300 milliseconds. Additionally, we will rotate the plus icon by 135 degrees upon hovering to create the illusion of transforming into a cross symbol. Once again, the transition property is used to ensure the rotation is smooth and gradual. As we progress, let's ensure that social icons hidden beneath the plus sign also react to the hover state. We will use the nth of type pseudo class to target specific anchor tags, then adjust their positions accordingly. The CSS calc function is used to calculate their new offset. First, we add the icon width and 8 pixels of gap between icons. then multiplying by their nth position among siblings of the same type, and finally adding 16 pixels of spacing from the bottom edge will result in an updated position. For example, for the second element, the addition of the width and gap is multiplied by 2, and for the third element, it's multiplied by 3. This ensures each icon is correctly positioned based on their stacking order. As usual, the transition property is used to ensure a smooth transition. Lastly, to maintain consistency throughout the design, we can apply the same color change effect for the social icons as well. Currently, this effect works only when we use the mouse to hover over the card. But nothing happens when we use the keyboard to traverse the page. To ensure accessibility for keyboard users, let's implement some enhancements to our layout. For instance, the focus within pseudo-class can be utilized to update the bottom positions of social icons. This pseudo-class triggers whenever a parent itself or any of its children enters the focus state. Similarly, the rotation and color change effects for the plus icon can also be improved by using the focus within pseudo-classes. Then, the focus visible pseudo-class can become handy for initiating the color change effect for the social icons. And finally, we can style the focus indicator to match our design guidelines. This small improvement will ensure our layout is accessible to all users, regardless of their input method. For more information about focus pseudo-classes and their role in accessibility, check out our detailed video explaining their implementation and use cases. To sum up, we have covered a sleek hover effect to enhance the visual appeal and functionality of our profile card layout. By incorporating keyboard accessibility features and ensuring smooth transitions, we can make our designs welcoming to all users. Remember, effective web design is not just about aesthetics, it's also about usability and inclusivity. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with others, and subscribe to our channel for more informative content. Your support helps us continue creating valuable tutorials like this one. Thank you for watching and see you next time.